In this video, I will talk about a special type of integer programming problems called the Knapsack Problems. Suppose there is a fire in John's apartment. He decides to take some valuable items and get out of the building. There are four valuable items. Each item is associated with a weight and a value. For example, item 1 weighs 5 pounds and is worth $1,600, and so on. Suppose John can only use one knapsack that holds a maximum weight of 14 pounds. Which items should he put in the knapsack and take with them so the total value is maximized? We can formulate this problem as a binary integer programming problem. We define xj is equal to 1 if John takes item j. Xj is equal to 0 otherwise. We try to maximize the total value of the items put in the knapsack, which is the objective function. In the constraint, the total weight of the items put in the knapsack should not exceed 14 pounds. In general, a knapsack problem is a pure integer programming problem with a single constraint. In most applications, all knapsack decision variables are binary. We can use the branch and bound method introduced in a previous video to solve this problem. In the branch and bound method, we can use a simplex algorithm to find the optimal solution to the linear programming relaxation of the knapsack problem. There is actually another easier method to solve the linear programming relaxation thanks to the special structure of the knapsack problem. First, calculate the value-weight ratio for each item. It represents the value per pound of an item. The best item has the largest value-weight ratio, and the worst item has the smallest value-weight ratio. We can put the best item in the knapsack first, then put the second best item in the knapsack, and so on. Continue in this fashion until the best remaining item will overfill the knapsack. Then fill the knapsack with the fractional number of this item. This will be an optimal solution to the linear programming relaxation. Let's calculate the value-weight ratio for this knapsack problem. The ratio for the first item is 3.2. For the second item, it's 3.14. For the third, it's 3. And for the last, it's 2.67. First, we will put item 1 in the knapsack. Its weight is 5 pounds. Because the capacity of the knapsack is 14 pounds, so it can hold another 9 pounds. Then let's put item 2 in. Now the remaining capacity is 9 minus 7 is 2 pounds. After that, we cannot put item 3 wholly into the knapsack because it will overfill. We can put only a half of item 3 in the knapsack to fill the remaining capacity, which is 2 pounds. So x3 is equal to 0.5. Last, because the knapsack is full now, we cannot put any item 4 in, so x4 is 0. The total value of the items is 16 times 1 plus 22 times 1 plus 12 times 0.5, which is $4,400. Remember, this is just the optimal solution to the linear programming relaxation. And it's not the optimal solution to the original knapsack problem yet. You can start from here and use a branch and bound technique to find the optimal solution to the knapsack problem. Let's check another example that belongs to the type of knapsack problems. It doesn't have anything to do with real knapsacks though. A wind turbine's electricity generation capacity can be increased by adding 4 different features. If we add feature 1, the related cost would be $10,000, and the capacity can be increased by 16 kilowatts, and so on. The goal is to maximize the capacity gain without exceeding a budget of $25,000. To formulate this problem, we define xj is equal to 1 if feature j is added. Xj is equal to 0 otherwise. we try to maximize the total capacity gain, which is the objective function. In the constraint, the total cost of the features added should not exceed $25,000. Now, suppose the requirement is changed to this. We want to increase the capacity by at least 40 kilowatts, and we want to minimize the total cost. To formulate this problem, the variables are still the same. One difference is that this is changed to a minimization problem. The other difference is that the original objective function is changed to the constraint function, and it is supposed to be greater than or equal to 40 kilowatts. The original constraint function, which is the total cost, is now the objective function. We can solve the problems using the branch and bound method. Okay, that is all about knapsack problems. Thanks for watching.